Hi all, a quick quick playthrough and a quick tutorial on the song Ben from the book Great Winners for Treble Brass. If you've not got the book, I'll put a link in the description of where you can get the book. I don't really want to put scans of books online for people to download, because that's a bit copyright and people might start knocking at my door. So I'll put a link on where you can buy the book. And the book is great. It's like 70 tunes, some really good tunes for brass. The book Great Winners for Treble Brass is sort of grade 3 to 5-ish. So if that's where you're at, this might be quite good. It's got things like Raiders March, dum ba dum bam, bam ba dum, as a grade 5 tune. And this is one of the early ones. So this is one of the slightly easier ones. So I thought I'd just walk you through it. So 4 beats and a bar. Let's just get the nice tempo. Okay, here we go. Ben from Great Winners for Treble Brass. 2, 3. Repeat. Alrighty then, let's dive into that, shall we? So if you've got the book, and yeah, do go and get it, because I will be referring to bar numbers and things like that, sections, etc. It's on page 2, right at the very beginning. This tune is actually really quite straightforward. The first two bars, as a lot of the times with music, the first phrase or the first section or the first few bars even can inform the rest of the piece. So nail the first two bars and you go, right, that is the next two bars is just a copy of that, but a bit this. They'll use the rhythm or they'll use the notes or the ideas or the devices through the music. So here, the first two bars. That rhythm gets repeated all over this place. Da, 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 da. Nail that and you'll get a lot of it, for the rest of it for free. The first three notes, I've had some students not quite nailing the first few notes. Da, da, da. That is what you'll hear me say if you get taught by me, a sausage roll rhythm. Da, da, da. A lot of students can't quite get their head around quavers, they've got it. Semiquavers, they get that. But the dotted crotchet, their brain just goes, I don't get that. Triplets even, fine. Dotted crotchets, they're what? But I call it a sausage roll rhythm. Sausage roll. But I don't have many word mnemonics for music because I find that they just get in the way of the learning. But I think that this is quite a useful one. Sausage roll. Da, da, da. Then you've got a load of quavers. Ba, da, 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 da. Get a metronome. Get a metronome. and just play it with the metronome slowly. But it's easier to speed up correct music than it is to correct fast music. So, slowing it down. Well, that's a bit of about that speed. So. Get it right, polish it up. Once you've got that, go round and round and round it 10 times, 20 times. Stick it on a metronome. Increase the metronome by 5 beats per minute. See how fast you can go. Go even faster than the piece. Just see how where your limits are. When you slow it down, it becomes much easier. The two bars after that, same thing. Da, 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 da. Except the last note is higher. The jump is there. B flat is a big jump. You've got to make the three things you need to get from a low note to a high note in a brass on a brass instrument. Three things. One, you might need to move the fingers. You might not, but you might need to use the fingers. Here you do, C to B flat. Secondly, the air needs to increase. The pressure, the speed needs to increase. Ba wa ba, or at least the pressure needs to be there. The power needs to be there, and the lips needs to get tighter around here. If you do all those three things simultaneously, you're much more likely to get those top notes out. The next four bars. Da 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 da. It's the same rhythm. It's the same that first bar. Like, oh, it's the same as that. It's the same as that. Same as that. And in fact, actual fact, some of them are just repeated. Three times. Rest, ba da ba. So you've got some semicolons. Ducka, 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 ducka. Ba da ba. Da da, three, four, one. And a two. So the F is right on beat two. It's important to know where you. It's important for you to know where the beats are on the. Looking at the music. There's beat one, there's beat two, beat three, and beat four. If you don't know where it is, you can have a metronome going all day long, but you have no idea where to put the notes. A bit too fast, but you have no idea where to put the notes because you're reading it. I don't know where that note is or what beat that is, and there's no point in knowing where the beat is but not listening to a metronome or having a beat going here. This beat here, or a metronome, has to link up with what you see. So that's your first section. You've got a first time bar, so you're going to repeat back to the beginning when you get the two lines, the two bar lines and the two dots. You go back to the beginning, and when you get to that big long bracket with a number one, that's at the number one cave, you've been in there already. Jump to number two and then carry on. So it's like you're repeating a section with two different endings. The first time round ending and the second time round ending. You don't play the first time round ending the second time. You've done it the first time. I don't want to play it again. Jump over it to number two. And then in here it looks to be pretty much the very similar ending. Then you've got section B. There's a lot we can talk about with that. I was talking to a student just the other day about how boring that was. It is boring if you don't do anything with it. It's like, where is this? To make music interesting, you've got to find the interest, the essence, the tension. Where, what do you want to bring out? What are the important notes? Forget about the non-important notes. Don't care about them. Bum, pa-da-da, dee-da-da. You want to bring out those interesting ones. And once you do that, the music's got shape. It's not, every note is equal. You go, oh, that's where I'm going. That's what I'm saying. Very much like when you're talking, you have important syllables to bring out and other ones that you don't. The ones that you bring out and the ones you leave behind. You don't go behind. So that shapes how you speak, and the same thing happens with music. So that middle section, try and find the interest. Find out what you want to bring out. We could start talking about vibrato, but I think that's for another day. So that section B, those four bars I've just played, get repeated exactly the next four bars. So it's just four bars. Ba-da-da, da-da-da, do-do-do, do-do-do. Again, ba-da-da, 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 ba-da-da. But again, find the interest. Then it goes back to theme A again. Try and get those slurs in. People don't think slurs are important. They are important. They really define, again, the important notes and the not important notes. Exactly the same as the beginning. Then you've got a nice... music does this. They save the high notes for the end. They think it's... they think it's going to be it's more, you know, musically interesting if they put save the high notes for the end. Again, it's the fireworks go off. But as a trumpet player, man, you're knackered by the time you get to there. Nevertheless, we've got to do it. So, oh crikey, where's my screen gone? There we are. So, your top D's here. First valve, lips have got to be really tight, make that vibration really small right towards the center, which means there's a lot of muscles required in the chops. Lots of power down here. You've got to really be pushing it through because that hole is smaller, or the vibration is smaller. You need to have more power to maintain that same speed. And then you've got your ending there. So you're, it's just basically that same bum bum ba da da bum bum da da da. It's just a nice sort of winding down ending to it. You know, you've had your ba da da, which is the peak of the whole piece where the tension is. La da 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 da. Strings are going. There's fireworks happening. Oh, there's love happening on the dance floor. And then ba da da boo ba la da. You're kind of landing the plane. Be da la da. Or bringing the boat into a jetty. At the end. So that there is my analysis of Ben from Great Winners for Treble Brass. I will try and remember to put a link where you can get it into the description, but I get it from a website called musicroom.com, and they are seem to be very good at getting music out very quickly and reliable. Anyway, right, play along, enjoy yourself, get a metronome. Bye.